Throughout U.S. history, people have rebelled against the status quo for all sorts of reasons. But in the 1700s, one rebellion revolved around whiskey. Believe it or not, the alcoholic beverage was the subject of a Pennsylvania tax uprising that lasted for 3 years. Western Pennsylvania, September 6, 1791. 8 months after the federal government imposes a whiskey tax to pay off debts incurred during the Revolution, tax collector Robert Johnson is doing his rounds when a group of men disguised as women drag him into the woods and cover him with hot tar and feathers. The message is clear. Among the working-class farmers and distillers of Pennsylvania and beyond, the whiskey tax is not welcome. Despite his initial opposition to the tax, President George Washington warns of an armed response. But the violence continues. On July 17, 1794, it comes to a head when the mob surrounds the home of a wealthy tax collector and burns it to the ground. Washington reacts by leading a militia of around 13,000 men to quell the rebellion once and for all. But he meets no resistance because the majority of insurgents had fled. Still, almost 150 are rounded up as suspects. 10 are tried for treason, 2 are convicted, but pardoned by Washington himself. At a time when many believed the newly established U.S. federal government was too weak to lead the nation, Washington's handling of the whiskey rebellion showed that it had the power and the will to stamp down hard on those who questioned its authority. Why is it important that the federal government has the ability to create and enforce laws that apply to all states?